Let's start with movable chords. A lot of times you know a chord in first position, but you're not aware of how it moves. And chords move up the neck just as notes move on the piano keyboard or the guitar neck or whatever. If this is a D7, and we move that a whole step or two frets up the neck, it becomes an E7, half step between E and F, F7, G7, A7, B7, and so on. So although you may know this chord down here, now you know that you know the chord any place on the neck if you know how notes move and where the half steps fall. So let's take a look at this D7 shape on the third fret. This is a chord you will see all the time in blues and E. You play it down here, or you might be playing a shuffle pattern, but it's nice to get out of first position and slide that D7 shape to the third fret, which gives us an E7. Our low E is the bass in the root right there for you. Now we move that up to the 8th fret, and 5 becomes our root in the bass. It really helps to know that root and help establish the chord. We move that up to the 10th fret, we have a B7, but we have no open string B to use in the root there. So what we'll do, if you like a little bit more of a bass at the bottom of that chord, is use your index finger on the 4th string, the 9th fret, which means you have to finger this triangle-shaped chord differently in order to put that in there. You can also use that on your A if you like, but that's going to be the best bass note you've got for that B7. So let's look at another shape here. Actually, before we do that, let's try this one more time just so you can get an idea of how far you have to move. Also, pay attention to your fret dots, because they're going to help you out as you move up the neck. So we have an E7 shape, an E7, that's a D7 shape with the third fret, an A7 at the 8th fret with 5 as your bass, and we have a B7 at the 10th fret. Let's do that one more time. E7, A7, B7, and now with the bass notes. So I'm sort of doing a pinch, my thumb is playing the bass. I'm going to strum up with one or two fingers and pinch them together. So here's our E, here's our A, here's our B7, or here. Now let's try one more movable chord, and that's the A7 shape that you know as a partial bar chord, barring 4 strings of the 2nd fret and adding whatever finger is comfortable. I use my 3rd finger at the 3rd fret of the 1st string. One more movable chord, which moves very nicely because it comes from this long A shape, which then moves down to a 7th. So you can do all kinds of movement holding your bar in place the whole time. So now we move that to the 4th fret, and we do the same thing. And what chord would that be? If this is an A, this would be a whole step higher. That's your B chord, or your 5 chord in the key of E. Now if we move that whole chord up to the 9th fret, that's our long A shape on the 9th fret, which is an E major chord. Here's the E7. So let's try that again. A on the 2nd fret, B on the 4th fret, and E up on 9. Okay, we're going to try a little Delta blues exercise, and Delta blues is based on the concept of the monotonic bass. That's a big word. Monotonic means one beat, one stroke per beat. 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're going to involve a little bit of syncopation here. We're going to first start with our E7 shape, our D7 shape actually. That's an E7 on the 3rd fret. And what we're going to do is just pinch that chord, and you can do this by just brushing up with your index finger or brushing with two fingers if you like, but we're just going to pinch with the bass note. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now let's turn that into eighth notes, which is a little bit more exciting. This is where the thumb always wants to go twice, but we're only going to let it go once for every brush of the treble strings. So watch closely, because my thumb will hit once for every two strokes of the index finger. One, and two, and three, and four, and that makes up one measure of a 12-bar blues or a whatever style blues tune you're doing. That's one, two, three, four. So let's go up to the eighth fret with the same chord, and five becomes our bass. So here we go. One, and two, and three, and four, and. Then up to the B7 on the 10th fret, and that's where we need to throw that bass note in. One, and two, and three, and four, and. Okay, let's try that now with our A7 partial bar shape. And actually, since we're in the key of E, let's start here on the 9th fret. And let's start with just the 7th shape. So our root is at 6. One, to the 2nd fret with the 5th string as the root. 1, 2, 3, 4. Up to the 4th fret, and our 4th string now will be the bass note. 1, 2, 3, 4. And back up to 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. Now that you have that syncopation going, we're going to syncopate a little bit more. We're going to throw in a triplet where we were doing an eighth note before. So we'll have three brushes of the index finger to one bass note, and it'll sound like this. One, and a, two, and a, three. Now your thumb is going to want to go with every one of those brush strokes. You can only let it go on the one. One, two, three, bass, bass. Good. Let's take it up to the A on the 8th fret. You can slide it if you like. Back to the 3rd fret. Delta style and a little bit of syncopation, and now you're getting up out of first position, up off away from your regular chords that we tend to get very comfortable with, and it's nice to get away and get some different chord voicings of those chords. And now a quick review of the A7 chords. B7 at the 4th fret, E7 on 9. So what we're going to try now is a little bit of an exercise to give you some options. We're going to mix and match the two chord shapes, the short bar and the D7 shape. So let's remember here we go, here's our E7 here, E7 here, B7 here, A7 here, B7, and back to E. So we're going to do that same delta style. There is no right or wrong here. So you do what you want, and I will do what I want, and let's see what happens here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice instrumental break, and it gets you away from the first position and into some nice chord voicings up the neck. Nice way to take a little instrumental break as a solo player, keeping the thumb going all the time. And that may be the hardest thing for you, is keeping that thumb going no matter what syncopation is going on in the treble strings, but that's a good thing to work on. Also, I have a slightly muted thing going on here in the right hand. I'm laying the heel of my hand against the bass string, so instead of the bass ringing out like this, I get more of a bounce feel like that. Now, another simple technique you can use is to use part of the scale. Let's just break it down into four notes here. Your G with a slight bend on the first string, your open E string, C sharp, and B. We're going to do a little exercise using those four notes in any order, together or singly, with the bass note. Same delta style we just did. Once again, do your own thing with these notes. Here we go with the sixth string open as the root note. 2, 3, 4. Just simple tricks you can use as a solo player to keep the bass going and have all the band parts going at the same time. You can play pentatonic scales if you like, but I find it's more interesting to use movable chords and little parts of scales so that you can keep your open bass notes going. This also works very well in the key of A, because you've got four open bass notes there, so you might want to try the same kind of thing in the key of A.